Good evening. Today, as we promised, we'll be discussing the sleep disorders. And the sleep disorders have been minimally taught in the psychiatry classes, maybe discussed much more in the, you know, the physiology, but not much in the psychiatry. So today, because the, you know, the JIPMER has redefined the, welcome Dr. Megha, and we just will learn okay. So sleep disorders, the basically, we all have been learned and taught, but this narcolepsy MCQs, two MCQs in the JIPMER, made it much more relevant, much more important topic to appreciate. I thank you so much who joined us on time. So let's do the MCQ and try to understand the sleep disorders with MCQs. This is just a brief introduction about our batches. My code is drsandeep-yt. You will get an extra discount, means discount of 10% only through the various codes, and it will be promotion of me only if at all you use this code for joining the Unacademy platform. 24/7 learning platform where you can enjoy learning at the comfort of your home. We are running a free live special classes, and the ritual time of that is 7 p.m. every Thursday. Slides also will be shared with you. Even the special classes, you can take a PDF printout or PDF with you and keep with you for further learning. So this is a brief that you can attend the free live classes, and you can subscribe for the plus courses by just paying 22,500. So if you apply the, you know, the discount code of 10%, it will be less than 20,000. In that also you can choose the EMI option by various banks. So please come and enjoy the course. We have the YouTube sessions where we'll be having the 5 MCQ in 15 minutes, 5 image based question in 15 minutes, and it's a fixed time. So anytime you wish to do the image based question, 6 p.m. you can tune in to the Unacademy platform and you will get up the MCQs of the image based MCQs. So it's all fixed up time, that any which time you wish to look for syndrome. The 9:45 will be a syndrome, new syndrome will be discussed, and the flashcard series, and the free classes will be like this. So 9 a.m. there will be a fast revision for basics, 7 p.m. there will be a previous year questions, 9 p.m. will be there as a quiz, and clinical MCQ at 10 p.m. and the image based question at the 11 p.m. and that's a free MCQs, free classes. You can interact also here, directly ask queries on this, though limited for every, you know, once in a week for a particular subject, but yes, you can be a part of a live learning on an academy platform. So that's what is the marketing about our June batch. It's a foundation batch course for NEET PG 2021, started on 18 June and taught by the best of the educators in the industry. So we welcome you all before sleep. So that's a question from the psychosexual psychiatry. But just to know that when does the nocturnal phenylstimulants occur? We know they are happening in the, what is the correct answer? Correct answer is that see and they can be monitored. Very good. But C is the very good Dr. Sai Yash. So that's a wonderful. So we just try to settle up the your point so that I could see you on the front. So that's all about this, but the question has been invited. We know sleep is a basically starts with NREM sleep. After 90 minutes we'll have a REM sleep. As night progresses, REM increases in frequency and duration. Okay. So that's like this NREM, 90 minutes REM sleep will come. And then NREM and then REM. So REM is increasing as the night is progressing. So that is a question about the circadian rhythm. We know that if the external source is removed, the daily human sleep cycle is about something more than 24 hours. And if the day and night cycle, the effect of the light, effect of the job has been taken away, it is more than or less than 24 hours. We know it is around 25 hours. So it's basically a spectrum from 23.8 to more toward 27.4 hours. But its best is the around 24 hours. So answer would be, it is more than 24 hours. So we know the human circadian rhythm is usually more than 24 hours. Okay, right, sir? Okay. Now, done? Now the deadly MCQ, all are true about narcolepsy except. So all are true about narcolepsy except the daydreaming, hypnagogic hallucination. So the question has gone beyond this simple question of daydreaming, hypnagogic hallucination, cataplexy, sudden sleep and decreased REM latency. So answer, I would be saying the answer is the very good Dr. Sai Ram. Answer is A. So we know that narcolepsy is a hot MCQ these days. We'll talk about that in a short while in detail. But it's a pentad of sleep attack, sudden sleep attack, sleep paralysis. There is a hypnagogic and hypnopompic hallucination. And it's a REM intrusion. So it's a disorder of the, that is also an MCQ. Disorder of the REM sleep. It's a disorder of the REM sleep. So, maximum duration of the time is spent in which of the following NREM state? It is in, we'll go back to details of narcolepsy in a short while so that you all stay. I'm just joking. So, we enjoy the narcolepsy in detail because last two MCQs are the MCQs which is asked in JIPMER. So, it will be good if at all we enjoy the narcolepsy there. So, we know the maximum stage is in the stage 2. Very good, Dr. Sir. So stage 2 is the maximum duration of the sleep. Very good. So not a feature of the paradoxical sleep. Rapid eye movement, decreased muscle tone. We know there is a rapid eye movement, there is a muscle tone which is decreased. Brain shows the increased metabolism and EEG has a increased activity. So answer would be D. Very good, Dr. Sairam. I would say that there is a question asked about the what is the frequency of each wave. So I remember it like that, D tap. Delta wave is 1 to 4 hertz. Theta is 4 to 7 hertz. And alpha wave frequency is 8 to 13 hertz. And beta is a 13 to 30 hertz. So it will be easy to remember. I make a mnemonic of the, it's a D tab. Delta 1 to 4 hertz, theta 4 to 7 hertz, alpha 8 to 13 and beta 13 to 30 hertz. Now the slow wave in the hippocampal area is, from the hippocampal area, the wave is the, dekhiye, alpha is mainly in the parieto occipital. That's a flaw, garbad hai. It is not delta. Beta is mainly from the frontal lobe. Theta is basically from the hippocampal area. For delta wave, they are seen in the stage 3 and the 4 of the REM sleep. So we don't have that. REM sleep, we have a pontogeniculo occipital spikes by the cholinergic neurons in the pons region projecting to the geniculate body and then to the occipital region. They are seen in the REM spikes. So that's slow wave in the hippocampal area is a theta wave, dot sir. Very good, Dr. Megha. Very good. So now we have the best test for assessing the sleep. It's the actigraphy. Among the barograph, chymograph, plethysmography, the best test would be the actigraphy. It's a very simple instrument like a watch. We all carry nowadays watch, smart watch, which can be tied upon, which record all the something like a smart watches we wear. That is what is the actigraphy, but that is much more accurate and not glamorized as in the smart watches. Okay, we know we all use the sports watch, smart watches nowadays. That's a question simply done because we have learned that pontogeniculo occipital spike is characteristic feature of which of the following disorder? It's a stage REM disorder. D. All of you can participate outside, it will motivate us. Alpha rhythm, we know, it sleep in the sleep with eyes closed, mind wandering, or awake with the eyes open. It is basically awake with the eyes open and eyes closed. Once sleep with eye, so it will be the A. Eyes open, awake means mainly a theta wave, sorry, beta wave. So Dr. Chakra, Dr. Alpha rhythm is seen in the sleep with eyes closed and mind wandering. Or better, we should not say sleep, but it's a awake with the, more better would be the awake with eyes closed and mind wandering. So parieto occipital region with subject awake and eyes closed. सवाल वही घूम घूम के आ रहा है बार बार. वी नो द आंसर इज भटकता आत्मा. वेरी गुड. सो वन क्वेश्चन इज अगेन एंड अगेन आस्क्ड एंड दैट इज द अगेन डॉक्टर प्रिया ठाकुर, डॉक्टर साई यश राम. सो दैट्स अ अल्फा वेव्स. सो वी आर प्लानिंग टू डू द स्पेशल क्लास ऑन थर्सडे. वी हैव एवरी थर्सडे 7 PM. सो वुड यू लाइक टू सजेस्ट एनी टॉपिक डॉक्टर साहब? वेरी गुड, ऑल ऑफ यू से राइटली. पराइटो एसोपिटल इज अल्फा, बीटा इज एट द फ्रंटल लोब, थीटा इज द हिपोकैम्पल एरिया एंड सो ऑन. क्लोजली एसोसिएट विद द स्लो वेव स्लीप और व्हाट यू कॉल डीप स्लीप. सो डीप स्लीप वी नो वी हैव अ स्लीप वॉकिंग, स्लीप टॉकिंग, डिप्रेशन और एंजाइटी डिसऑर्डर. ओके, सो शैल वी टेक अप अ फर्स्ट क्लास ऑन डिप्रेशन, द कंसेप्ट ऑफ द डिप्रेशन एंड ऑल अबाउट द डिप्रेशन, ओनली डिप्रेशन, टॉकिंग, ब्रक्सिज्म एंड यू कैन सजेस्ट एनी टॉपिक इफ यू विश. चलेगा? वेरी गुड. और लोगों का क्या कहना है डॉक्टर साहब, बताइए. स्लीप टॉकिंग, स्लीप वॉकिंग, ब्रक्सिज्म, नाइट टेरर वी हैव इन दी डीप स्लीप और दी एनआरईएम स्लीप, अटोनिया, ड्रीमिंग, इरेगुलर हार्ट रेट विल बी दी. बट यू ऑल हैव टू ज्वाइन, अदरवाइज दे विल यू नो दी मैनेजमेंट आस्क मी व्हाट टॉपिक यू आर डूइंग. We'll do the MCQs also, but we'll enjoy the theory of depression, the concept of depression, and then do the MCQs. May not be 1 hour, it can extend to 15 minutes more, and we'll enjoy that. Okay? Very good. NREM sleep, what all we see? So, bruxism is the only disorder we... ACD, yes, very good. No, teeth grinding is... ब्रक्सिज्म डॉक्टर साहब. नाक कोलैप्स इज अ डिसऑर्डर ऑफ दी REM स्लीप. नाइट मेयर आर इन दी REM स्लीप एंड स्लीप पैरालिसिस हैपन इन दी REM. सो आंसर इज डॉक्टर अमृत, डॉक्टर मेघा, डॉक्टर कनिका, दैट्स ऑल. आंसर इज ए. वेरी गुड. ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस ऑफ नाइट टेरर वी ऑल नो इज अ शॉर्टर एक्टिंग बेनाडाज़ेपिन. That is Meprobamate. Night terrors, we prefer the short acting benzodiazepine, that is clonazepam, I would say. Pavor nocturnus is a sleep terror. We know the night terror happen in the stage 3 and 4 of NREM sleep. They are all parasomnias, disturbance of the quality of sleep. Bruxism happen in the 2, somnolence happen in 3 and 4 again, and sleep talking stage 2, 3 and 4 of NREM. In REM we have nightmares, that is dreams. Okay. Done, Doctor Sir? Now, not true about narcolepsy. There is a sudden sleep and cataplexy. So narcolepsy has evolved in the MCQ. Evolved as an MCQ matlab. Jipmer has been asking the deeper and deeper and deeper MCQs about the narcolepsy. But that shows that it has not deviated from narcolepsy. So welcome you all to join. Dr. Sumant, the answer is very good, BBB, very good. It is a 20 minutes sleep attack. Okay. Presents in second decade, cataplexy, sudden sleep, sleep paralysis. There is a abnormal REM intrusion in EEG. And hypnagogic and hypnopompic hallucination. Hypnogram and the EP worth. That's how I think we will be reh jayega. I am also not prepared for telling that detail. Let's enjoy narcolepsy today. And we'll do that sometime in other YouTube. About the hypnogram and... But that is not asked to you. EP worth, assessment, wo sab evaluation ka naya DSM-5 mein aaya hai. But that is not been, I think, will be asked to you. But they can ask anything because they are gone deep in the REM. And this narcolepsy. So first they ask you in the JIPMER, the most common type is a visual hallucination. The hypnagogic is while it's a hallucination while going to bed. I never hear voices, but the moment I am about to go to bed, there is a hallucination. Hallucination while waking up from sleep. Please mind G and the G. Gogic is while going to sleep, and pompic is while waking up from sleep. Okay. Now the drug used is the modafinil, and modafinil is approved by FDA for treatment of all of the following except, we know it is used in the OSAS, narcolepsy. No, it's a drug of choice except, puchha doctor sahab, except in the lethargy in depression, for the shift work syndrome, for the narcolepsy, for the obstructive sleep apnea syndrome, it is the drug of choice. But yes, okay, very good. So not to be used, no, that's it is used, but it is not to be used for lethargy in depression. Dr. Sumant, not to be used for that. It is used for the OSA. So we know it's a disorder of the REM sleep. We have hypnagogic hallucination. We have the... It switch on the... Jo button band ho gaya hai, jo switch on ho rakha hai, us button ko off karna hai. We'll just discuss that in detail, Dr. Sir. Mechanism of action and how does it, the narcolepsy sleep happens. So that's all about the, yeah. And we know the most common hallucination in the hypnagogic and hypnopompic is the visual hallucination. Very good, doctor. First, Dr. Chikara and Dr. Meghna. And the center of the narcolepsy lies in A, nahi hai, doctor. The hallucination is the visual, and the center of the narcolepsy lies in the pons, medulla, hippocampus, neocortex. It's in the hippocampus because it's in the hypothalamus. It's in the hypothalamus. Now the Yeah, this is the questions from the JIPMER. Regarding the diagnosis of the narcolepsy, which of the following is true? True kya hai doctor sahab? Characterized by sudden onset of sleep, NREM sleep, we say no. Characterized by dopamine drug, no. Treatment is methylphenidate or modafinil. Sleep walking disorder, no. The correct is the associated with the major histocompatibility complex HLA. So, true is that it is associated with the MHC class 2, major histocompatibility complex, the human leukocyte antigen complex. We test it for the rheumatoid arthritis, many of the autoimmune diseases. So, it being associated with the HLA diseases, autoimmune nature, so there is also some improvement seen with the immunosuppressant in the narcolepsy. We'll enjoy that. Just theory padhte hain doctor sahab. Just 2 minutes dijiye. Which of the following statement about the narcolepsy is false? Type 2 can be caused by traumatic brain injury. Type 1 narcolepsy has hypnagogic hallucination caused by the loss of the hypocretin or oxcerin producing neuron in the hypothalamus. So the loss of the neurons which actually maintains the wakefulness, so they act like a switch which, you know, once on the person will be in the awake state. So as the lack of this hormone hypocretin and oxcerin in the hypothalamus, the person goes to sleep again and again. Answer is very good, that A. Type 2 narcolepsy has associated with the cataplexy. Now that's what I tell you, that this is a year of the narcolepsy by JIPMER. So we know it's a pentad, and they say it is a type 1 and type 2 narcolepsy. Type 1 is basically associated with low levels of CSF hypocretin and surely has cataplexy. Type 2, so whether the CSF level may be anything, but in this type 1 we always have a cataplexy. Type 2 on the other hand has everything same but lacks cataplexy. In both the types, the important point is that one is that the CSF hypocretin is a low. In both of them, there is a hypnagogic and hypnopompic hallucination. Dono ke andar hi hypnagogic or hypnopompic hallucination hote hain. So that's what is the question, that type 2 has a hypnagogic hallucination. So whether it's a hypocretin low or not, type 1 is classically where the low CSF hypocretin and surely will have a cataplexy. Type 2 on the other hand is a lacking the cataplexy and but still having our all rest features of the narcolepsy. Also, now the current literature says it's of two types, idiopathic and induced by head injury or tumor. So idiopathic is that I tell you it is associated with the HLA. and they say that is why we may use immunosuppressant drug. By head injury, tumor, and may lack cataplexy because it is not, having the loss of the hypocretin or auxerin in the hypothalamus. So the neurons which produce the hypocretin and auxerin, they are lacking. So that is why it is there. So type 1, type 2 narcolepsy and the idiopathic and the induced narcolepsy. Now if we look back at the same MCQ, I think it will be easier. Type 2, we know this does not have cataplexy. Type 2 can be caused by the narcolepsy which does not have low CSF level of the hypocretin, can be caused by traumatic brain injury, because for the real narcolepsy, it is type 1 narcolepsy, it has to be due to loss of the such neurons which produce the hypocretin or auxerin in the hypothalamus. Whether it is type 1, whether it is type 2, we know we have all the rest feature common to both of them. So both these questions are correct. Now diagnosis of narcolepsy, we know, can be assured with the major histocompatibility complex class 2. HLA-2 it is there. And characterized by sudden onset of the REM sleep, not an REM sleep. And dopamine agonist are not used. It's a modafinil or methylphenidate which is used. And there is no disorder of sleep walking. It's a disorder of the REM sleep, not deep sleep. So that's we learned today, that type 1, type 2 and the idiopathic and the induced narcolepsy. So this is the 4 types of narcolepsy we learned today. Lot of MCQs has been asked in the JIPMER. From where the center to the neuron to the genes to the idiopathic, induced, type 1, type 2, association with the HLA-2. So they all asked you all about it. So that's all. Not true about the somnambulism among the following is. Not true is that we know it's a disorder of the sleepwalking occurring during the NREM sleep. And what we call as a disorder of sleep, it's actually we call it a disorder of the sleep wakeful disorder or sleep arousal disorder. So it's a disorder of the, answer is the D. It could be highly skilled activity from the homicide to running away can be done by the client suffering or experiencing the somnambulism. So it's a disorder of the sleep arousal, or what is being called as parasomnia, about the quality of the sleep. Now this is the question about the depression or schizophrenia or panic disorder or OCD. You have to tell us that. We know in psychiatry illnesses have been called functional disorder because there is no blood test, there is no urine test, there is no way that we can ascertain any psychiatric illnesses. And we know sleep study come as a respite, but still not proven, so not can be used for a diagnostic criteria. So answer is, a woman is evaluated in the laboratory and she had a decreased latency of REM sleep. Which of the following disorder is most likely to be suffering from? Bataiye, that's all. Chalega sab. We know in depression, what happen is there is a BBB, sab B pe aagaye. Yes, very good, Dr. Megha, Dr. Sai Ram. It is depression. We know in depression the REM frequency and duration increases. REM ki frequency duration badh jati hai. You must have seen patients who come to you that doctors have in depression that I could not sleep properly, I remain awake whole night. Pura raat sapne mein beet gaya mera to doctor saab. It is B, because of the in depression there is a REM frequency and duration increases, or what you said, decrease REM latency. REM is coming fastly. It's decrease REM latency. Okay. So we have learned disorders of sleep have been categorized as like about the quantity of sleep, about the quality of sleep. It is called as parasomnias. It is called as the dyssomnia. In dyssomnia, we could, you know, it could be insomnia. We could have hypersomnia. So we have learned the table of the parasomnia, NREM, REM. Okay. Nightmares, dreams, or what you call as the narcolepsy, their disorders of REM sleep. In NREM, sleep talking, sleep walking, bruxism, night terrors, and nocturnal aneurysis. This is a disorder of the REM, NREM sleep. ठीक है डॉक्टर साहब. So I think this is all we have for sleep. So any suggestion for topic? So you suggested me, I have to load it up. The depression, nomenclature and MCQs. Here in 1 hour, we'll complete about depression, the antidepressant drug, the side effect of the drugs, electric shock, when to give electric shock, or any other topic would like to suggest. Because if you suggest, you have to attend it Thursday, 7 p.m. It's a free lectures. We'll post up in Telegram link. My Telegram is also Dr. Sandeep Govil. So you can take a lead from there. The modafinil in short. Modafinil basically, it increases the activity at the ascending reticular activating system. So it increases the activity and discharges in the ARAS, which is our alert keeping mechanism of the human brain. So this drug acts at the ARSA and they thereby increase my alertness. So many people abuse it in the call center's duty or to, you know, shift duties, but basically approved by FDA only for the OSA, narcolepsy, and at time in the shift duties, but not for improving the lethargy or dullness of ADHD or the depression. On the other hand, we know the methylphenidate is used in both ADHD and the narcolepsy. So we know the next question, the drug of choice for narcolepsy is? Answer was methylphenidate. But now the answer is modafinil. We also have been asked, a drug which is used to treat both narcolepsy and ADHD. So that is the latest MCQ of the AIIMS. So with this, I thank you so much for joining us. And if you like us, please join this platform. And trust me, you will be learning many, many things from the best of the best educators in the country for every subject. So chun chun ke hira aapke liye rakha gaya hai. So that you can enjoy the learning and able to crack the exam with the expert guidance from the expert teachers in this field. So I welcome you to join the Unacademy or to enjoy at the YouTube platform or the, you know, the special classes platform, which is live free classes where you can interact, put up a doubt. IQ तो पता नहीं, डॉक्टर, थैंक यू सो मच डॉक्टर मेघा, डॉक्टर अनुश्री एंड डॉक्टर अमृत. IQ तो नहीं घटता है, बट देखिए, इट इज़ नॉट गुड. विल डिस्कस अबाउट दैट समटाइम इन दी अनदर यूट्यूब. वी विल कीप इट सेपरेट एंड ट्रस्ट मी, विल डिस्कस इन अ नेक्स्ट ऑफ द यूट्यूब सेशन द मोडाफिनिल एंड द मिथाइलफेनिडेट इन डिटेल. सो IQ तो नहीं गिर सकता इससे, बट इट लीड टू द ए मोटिवेशन, डिक्रीज इन द ड्राइव बिकॉज इट कीप्स द ब्रेन ऑलवेज एक्टिव. समटाइम इट मे लीड टू द डिक्रीज इन द मोटिवेशन लेवल्स वंस यू ओवर डू इट. टेलीग्राम नेम इज DR संदीप गोविल. You can join the Unacademy PG Live, so it will be posted there, but Telegram also it is easy. If you join it, I'll be sending it to the directly on this Telegram channel. So thank you so much, Dr. Sir. We'll see you soon on the next YouTube and at the special class on 7 PM on Thursday, and we'll do the depression on that day in total. Thank you so much. All the best.